You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
So now let's take a look at my final nodes. I'm going to select this roto node here. Actually, I'll disable this one first. And here are all my layers. I'll select them all. And I'll click the plus button here to open them all up. And you can see all the different, actually we can nest that back in. We'll just bring this up here and you can see all the layers and the shapes and the keyframes. One thing I want to just point out here, if you want to scroll through all the layers and keyframes, you can hold your mouse wheel over this line here and you can scroll down that way. If you want to compress or expand the timeline, you can mouse scroll inside the timeline window itself. So you can see down here there's just lots of layers and keyframes, lots of tracking. And we'll just bring this back down here. And then we'll just click the shift plus button, minus button there, and then it's all closed up again. And we'll just organize my trees window a little bit better. We can just use this to help organize, but I have such a small space when I'm teaching that I kind of have to fit it all in. Okay, so here I have the multi-node system when I do hair roto. I have my final node here that just has all my layers and shapes without any width set to the open shapes. And then I have my final node here where I set the widths, and you can actually label your nodes down here. And I have the roto final here where I'm setting shape blur and motion blur. So if I go to this section here, or this node here, I've set all the widths to about 1.2 or 1.5, and I won't go through that right now, but let's just zoom in here. And first, we'll just take a look at the roto final. You can see all this detail up here. Looks like all my hair strands are staying within my core shapes, which is good. And there's actually one other feature I want to point out right now, and that is to the feature where you can select all start or end points for open shapes. So we'll go into this node here. I'm going to just go into this layer here, which is the, let's just find this, the screen left. That's upper mid layer, not that one. There we go. So I'm going to go into this layer here, let's expand it and I'll unlock it. So here, if you select your open shapes and you select them all and make sure that they're all unlocked, if there's one locked, you won't be able to do anything. So I just sometimes just select them all, lock and then unlock, and they're all unlocked. And then you can go up to, you can go in the points mode, and looks like we have our core shape selected. Something is in here. Let's just unselect that. I'm not sure where that's coming from, but that doesn't quite matter at the moment. We'll go right click and we'll select all start or endpoints. So we'll select all endpoints. And this is good if you want to do a special edit to all the endpoints that are actually the endpoints. So you want to make sure that when you do this, that when you create your open shapes, that you're starting from one end and going to the other end. If I was starting for some of these shapes out here and going in and then in and going out, then it would be a selection that would not be uniform. So this is good for if you want to change the cap style. The default is flat, but it can be round. Or maybe you want to feather the end shapes or make them a point at the end. But first we have to set the stroke width, and we'll just set this to 3 to make it larger so we can see what's going on. And we'll zoom in even further. So now we're at the round and we can just set it to flat and around again. It's kind of setting both of them, but in any case, it's just a nice feature to have. We'll just zoom out again and we'll select all the points one more time. Okay, there's the core shape. Let's just turn that on. I'm not sure why that's turning on. Could be a duplicate in there. And we'll go back and change this down to 2 so we can see things a little bit better. So then if I want to select all the interior points, for example, like maybe my start points were too close to this line and they were going to show up if it was a lot of motion, I can go and just select, oops, it's right click. I'm so used to the actions menu. This is a new feature, so I'm just getting used to it. Select start points. So say I just wanted to move them into the head, they're all selected, I can just shift and now move my points in. So it's, you know, it's a feature that has a lot of uses and I'm still learning a bit more about it. And I'm just going to go back and set them to have a width of none. So 0, because this is my node where there is no width set to open shapes. And then we can go to our final set here where I set the widths, and we'll look at this in the alpha channel now that we can see them. Click A, and I'll turn off the overlays. I'll click A again, so now you can see the hair a little bit better. We'll zoom in. So there's lots of hair. They're all tracking pretty well. And then you can see there's a little bit of aliasing. So what I do in this next final node is that I apply a slight blur. And I do that to the overall node. It's very easy to change. I don't have to go in and change it per shape. And I'm also setting the motion blur. So if I toggle down here, you can see that motion blur is enabled as well as in the node itself. And then we can do our final render. And I've already done that. This is just actually more of a render, like a slap comp, so we can kind of see the work. You can either hand it off in mats like EXR or whatever format you need to, but I'll just bring this in here. It's actually already in here. Save time for rendering. And we'll just frame it in view and play it through. So it doesn't look like a lot of work, but it actually is quite a bit of work. We'll zoom in so you can see some more of that hair detail. There's some rogue hair shapes moving around here that needed keyframes on just about every frame. And then here is also a node just to look at, so you can kind of see all the shapes. Turn on the overlays. Okay, and then I have one last thing I want to show you here for the output. And this is where you can render shapes to channels. So we'll click on this node here. It's just a copy. And I've made a little note here that describes the process. First, we'll go up to our image here. And then we have our roto. Let's go out of the, hold on 1 second. Here we are. Here's the render. So a reason why to do this, if you want to render shapes to channels, if you want to combine more mats inside a file format to save space. Since we have a JPEG, we only have 3 channels, RGB, but if you had EXR, you would have 4 channels. And you can only apply it to like one channel per layer. You can't actually apply a whole layer to a channel, but maybe that would change in the future. So in this example, I am just using shapes inside the body here. So here, let's go down to, I did the shoulders and the upper hood, the screen left and screen right upper hood. So here with the shoulders, if I click on this shape and we go to the node, or rather the object window here, and actually, I think I have to unlock it. I'll go up to the body all and unlock that. Okay, then we click away and I go back freehand. And now you see I can edit in here. And we change the channel down here to blue. And then I can go to the screen left upper hood and do the same. So here you can see that it's set to red. And then for the screen right upper hood, it's set to green. And then if you want to view the channels, you can just use Alt R, G, and B. Alt R, Alt G, Alt B. And then you can render. But you want to make sure that you have this output here from the Roto node from the channels output. I'll just mouse over that channels into the output shapes. That's really important. If you don't do that, you won't get this output. So here's the output. I've already rendered it. And that's just another way to provide mats. We'll take one last look at the finished work. And here it is. This now concludes the instruction for this hair roto task. Silhouette is perfect for handling complex shots like these with hundreds, even thousands of shapes. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you have enjoyed this class and look forward to exploring everything that Silhouette has to offer.